Charlie Weems, age 20. Following the death of his mother and six of his seven siblings, his father had fell ill and sent him to live in Georgia with his aunt. Weems was just headed home after 16 years away with his aunt. Ozzie Powell, age 15, worked at many camps and many sawmills for a few weeks and months at a time from the age of 14. Being only 15, he was headed in Memphis in search of new work. Clarence Norris, age 19, following the death of his father, a former slave, Norris was headed to Memphis in search of a job. Olin Montgomery, age 17, had a large cataract in one eye and was basically blind, was headed to Memphis in search of work in order to buy some glasses. Haywood Patterson, age 18, was simply headed to Alabama in search of a job. Willie Robertson, age 16, headed to Memphis in search of free medical attention for his sexual transmitted diseases he had gained. Eugene Williams, age 13, was going to Memphis in order to find a job as well. Andrew Wright, age 19, was headed to Memphis with his younger brother and friends Haywood Patterson and Eugene Williams in search of a job. And Leroy Wright, age 13, left home for the first time in his life to find work with his brothers and his friends. A timeline of events. On March 25th, 1931, a Southern Railroad train is stopped in Paint Rock, Alabama. The nine boys are arrested on charge of assault. The very next day, which would be March 26, 1931, the Scottsboro Boys are nearly killed by a mob of people around the Scottsboro Jail. Some historians say these men were Klansmen from the nearest KKK membership. March 30, 1931. The nine Scottsboro Boys are charged with rape by a grand jury. April 6, 1931, Scottsboro trials open officially. And on April 7th through 9th, 1931, the eight oldest boys are convicted with rape and sentenced to death. And Roy, the youngest, age 13, has a mistrial. Prosecution asked for life of imprisonment, but some jurors wanted to hold out for the death sentence. April through December 1931, the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, also known as the NAACP, and the International Labor Defense, also known as the ILD, each want the right to represent the Scottsboro Boys to fight against this courtroom injustice. June 22nd, 1931, execution of the nine boys is held off until they are given a fair trial before the Alabama Supreme Court. On January 5th, 1932, in a letter to an acquaintance, Ruby Bates, one of the girls that had cried rape that dreadful day, admits that she was never raped, and that the two women were prostitutes, and that all of this was an effort to avoid charges from the Federal Mann Act that states you cannot pass between states for immoral purposes, which would be prostitution. And since the two ladies were passing through Tennessee to Alabama for moral purposes, they used the rape plea in order to avoid federal charges. And on March 1932, by a nearly unanimous vote, the Supreme Court affirms the boys' sentences. The only change is that Eugene Williams, a juvenile in 1931, did not receive the death sentence and is released in 1937. A change gonna come.
Oh, yes it will. Why is my topic important during this time period, you may ask? Well, when put in historical context, the Scottsboro trial is important to this period in time because it shows the struggle men faced in their efforts to find work. Because after all, these nine black men were just desperate for work, hoboing across America in boxcars in their effort to find a steady source of income. These 9 young black males were just as desperate as the Irish immigrants looking for work during the mid-1800s. Also, the trial shows that even though the Great Depression was in full swing, the nation had not fully dealt with the problems regarding racial injustice that were birthed during the Reconstruction era. During the Reconstruction era, many white men had an irrational fear of black men raping or attacking white women. And as you see in this case, that irrational fear extended to the Great Depression period as well. How does the Scottsboro trial represent social continuity during this time period, you may ask? Social continuity is a reoccurring motif in the story known as United States history. But the Scottsboro case is a prime example of social continuity in the justice system. But does social continuity have a positive or negative connotation? One would normally say positive because continuity usually relates to the betterment of something previously established. But regarding the Scottsboro trial, the only trace of notable social continuity was the social continuation of the marginalization of black men during the periods after his release from the shackles of slavery. The continuation of racial prejudice in the justice system, and the continuation of white man's crass attempts to keep black man subservient to him.